My name is Ron Yearwood. I am an urban designer at the Nashville Civic Design Center. If you're not familiar with the Nashville Civic Design Center, then you're probably hiding under a rock. We are a nonprofit organization that basically advocates for good urban design. I'm here to talk about a new project that we have going on this summer called Designing Action. This is a design competition. If you're not familiar with the Nashville Civic Design Center, you may be familiar with some of our past projects, including the Plan of Nashville. This is a community-based plan for the future development and redevelopment of Nashville. And, ideas from Plan of Nashville have led to other projects, including Riverfront Park, which the National Civic Science Center was also heavily involved with in the early phases. We were instrumental in getting together the major teams and helped facilitate public meetings, and also the design charrettes with Hargraves Associates. Another project that is near and dear to my heart is Moving Tennessee Forward. It was a publication in partnership with the Nashville Area NPO, showcasing over 400 illustrations addressing innovations in transportation, development, infrastructure, and public space. It's a tool to convey the ideas that are contained in the NPO's 2035 transportation plan. So Designing Action, this is a grant project that we received from the National Endowment of the Arts to host a design competition that reimagines the Nashville Industrial East Bank as an active, functioning place, focusing on alternative sports and new development. So why is this important? Well, there's a growing popularity for alternative sports in our nation. At the same time, Tennessee is one of the most unhealthy states in the U.S., coming in at fourth most obese. There are also mitigation issues with the site that we selected, including floodplain and brownfield due to existing industrial use. You may have seen a lot of press for this site, primarily as an eyesore as we enter downtown. This will become even more of a gateway with the completion of the new convention center and the upcoming Sober District. So two-thirds of the site happens to be in the floodplain. Can we do anything besides just more open space? Could this be a hub for alternative sports? Nashville is increasingly diverse and already a top U.S. sports city, ranking at number 16 in the nation. It's along the Cumberland River's east bank. The site is currently used for industrial purposes. Here's an image. You can see the condition of Nashville's beautiful Music City Bikeway underneath the muddy bulldozer tracks. Here's a large view of the site, its features. The site is 75 acres. It's actually pretty huge. You don't realize how big it is. Cheapwood actually fits in the site of 25 acres left over. 50 of the acres are in the 100-year floodplain, so it's also close proximity and walking distance downtown, sporting venues, residential neighborhoods. And the site has been envisioned many times before. This example comes from the Plan of Nashville. As you can see, it envisions the site as a highly dense, mixed-use neighborhood, reconnecting East Nashville by converting the interstate loop into an urban boulevard. It has also been conceptualized as an island, and I'm sure many of you have seen this concept before. This was part of the Riverfront Master Plan long-term vision. But this site, just to show you the kind of extremities that have been conceptualized. Other visions include work from UT architecture students, TK Davis, who used to be the design director at the Civic Design Center, now focuses all of his studio work in Nashville as urban design projects. And these are two examples of his architecture students doing urban design projects. And this is on the entire downtown East Bank, kind of incorporating some of those ideas. And then something happened. The May 2010 flood kind of caused people to step back and take a second glance at the previous proposals. So now it's kind of like, what actually makes sense for the science future. More recently, this site was featured in the Sounds Ballpark site evaluation study. And as you can see from this image, the stadium only takes up a portion of the site. We want to see creative ideas and how the site can be completely transformed. Our design competition officially kicked off June 1st. Submissions are due August 13th. Following the jury, the finalists will be on exhibit for a month this fall. There's $9,500 in award money, so I really encourage you all jobless or job-seeking people to sign up. So far, this is a map from all of our participants that have entered. There's still a month to go, so we expect another two continents to end the list, but right now we're at four continents and 12 different countries. So we're really hoping for more international games. We have several, but sign up if you haven't heard of it or are kind of waiting to the last minute. As I said before, the finals will be on exhibit. This is at Rolling Mill Hill's new extension of the Greenway, and this is right across the river from the site. Probably the top 10 projects will be on exhibit. And throughout the month, we plan to host several events to kind of activate that space. A lot of people haven't been there and don't know much about it. The first event, the day after we launch the exhibit, is Parking Day. It's a worldwide event, and it'll be the first time Nashville has participated. And the NCPC will be sponsoring and hosting and coordinating. And we'll be using our Young Urbanist group to help coordinate parking spots along around the town. The NCPC spot will be at the parking lot beside our exhibit. So please register now. If you need more information, designing-action.org, or if you want more information about the Civic Design Center, civiccenter.org, parkingday.org. Again, my name is Ron. I have more answers if you have more questions.
Thank you again for coming. I've got a list here. Thank you for coming. Thank you for our speakers. Without our speakers, we would just be sitting here drinking beer, which isn't bad. Thank you for our sponsors, ESA, the building, and Native. By the way, there are several Native magazines. Grab them. They are great. I already read it. I have a wish. I have a dream. I have a dream that someday this event will be sponsored by one person, a few people, and eventually these donations can go towards a certain charity every month or whatever we have these that we kind of choose. So if you have any ideas for sponsors, let me know, as well as presenters. We are shooting for the end of August, I think, for the next one, and then we're for Volume 8, and we're going to go ahead and start planning for Volume 9 as well, which may be themed. And my last note says, beer, drink. We have lots of beer left, so please drink up. Thank you for coming.